But how can we do that? How can we identify the purpose of the system and collect good requirements? To answer that question, let me give you another definition of requirements engineering. And this one is a classical one, one that summarizes what we discussed so far and that we can use as some sort of reference. And it is a little long, definitely longer than the one that we saw at the beginning, but it's an important one and contains a lot of very relevant points. So we're gonna go through it and highlight these points. So the definition says that requirements engineering is a set of activities concerned with identifying and communicating the purpose of a software-intensive system and the context in which it will be used. And this is exactly what we said at the beginning. But something that we can highlight in here is the fact that we're talking about a set of activities. So what that means is that requirements engineering is not just a phase or a stage. It also says that it's about identifying and communicating. And what that is telling us is that communication is as important as the analysis. So it's important to be able to communicate these requirements, not only to collect them. And we will discuss many reasons why that is the case. It explicitly talks about purpose. So that allows me to stress once more that quality means fitness for purpose. We cannot say anything about quality unless we understand the purpose. And the last thing I want to point out in this first part of the definition is the use of the term context. This is also something else that we mentioned at the beginning, that designers, analysts need to know how and where the system will be used. Without this information, you cannot really understand what the system should do and you cannot really build the system. So now let's continue and read the second part of the definition that says that, hence, requirements engineering acts as the bridge between the real-world needs of users, customers, and other constituencies affected by a software system and the capabilities and opportunities afforded by software-intensive technologies. This is a long sentence, but also here we can point out a few interesting and relevant points. Let me start by highlighting two parts, real-world needs and capabilities and opportunities. So what are these two parts telling us? They are telling us that requirements are partly about what is needed, the real-world needs of all these stakeholders. But they're also partly about what is possible, what we can actually build. We need to compromise between these two things. And finally, I would like to point out this term constituencies, which indicates that we need to identify all of the stakeholders, not just the customer and the user, so anybody who is affected by a software system. It is very important to consider all of these actors. Otherwise, again, we'll be missing requirements. We'll be missing part of the purpose of the system, and we will build a suboptimal system.